In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the example of condition testing. So let's see the example now. You are testing a photo enforcement system for traffic control in an intersection. Okay, so this is your system for which you are performing a testing. A photo will be taken if the following two conditions are true. So you will take a photo at the intersection only if these two conditions are true. So the red the light is red, okay, and it is represented as red. So whenever you see this word red, that means light is red. And the front wheel of the car are over the line marking the beginning of the intersection. So if the front wheel of the car is crossing the line, then you have to, and if the light is red, then you have to take the picture. And this is your system which you have to test. So now what they are asking next is, consider these set of values. So there are set of values which they are giving. The first set of value is red plus wheel. So now you have to see whether you have to take photo or not. So red means light is red. Wheel means the car is over the line. So now you have to capture the photo. Now if you go to the second condition, that is red plus not wheel, means light is red but wheel is not over the beginning line. So here you will not capture the picture. If you come to third option, so right, light is not red but wheel is above the or over the line. So here also you will not capture the picture. And the last option is not red, not wheel. That means the light is not red in color and the wheel is also not crossing the beginning of the marking. So here also you will not capture the photo. So only in the first condition you will capture the picture. So this is just for your understanding now. So now let's see what they are asking. Assume the logic in the code is as follow. So they are providing you a logic which you have to analyze now. So this is the logic. If red and wheels, that means red means light is red and wheels means the car is, the front wheel of the car is crossing the intersection. So in this case what you have to do? Take the photo. Else do not take the photo. So that is what we have seen from this particular requirement. Only in the first case the photo was taken and in all the other cases the photo was not taken. Because when light is red and wheel is crossing the beginning of the line, take the photo. So this is the code. So what is the question here? So the question is, given this information, which sets of values provides the minimum tests to achieve 100% condition coverage? So they are asking, what is the minimum number of tests you need in order to achieve 100% condition coverage? So now you have to understand the concept of condition coverage. Condition coverage means we have to look into the condition, and here the conditions are red and wheels. And now for this red and wheels, we have to cover true and false for red and true and false for wheels. The option they have given are, so in order to cover 100% condition coverage, first and four. That means first and four option if we select, then they are telling we can cover the 100% condition coverage. Or if we select 1 and 2, that is 1 and 2 and 1 and 3. 1 and 3. So 1 and 2 and 1 and 3 if you select, then also you can cover 100% condition coverage for this code. Or the next option they are telling you is, you have to execute all the conditions. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you execute all these 4, then you are covering the 100% condition coverage here. Or if you are only executing 2 and 3. So if you execute 2 and 3, then also you are covering the condition coverage. So that is what they are telling you here. So now what we will do is, we will put each of these condition in a pair of 2, because in all the options they are giving you in 2 pairs. And then we will see which one is the answer to achieve 100% condition coverage. So now let's start with the analysis of this question. So this was the code. If red and wheels, then take the photo, else do not take the photo. And the conditions given were these. So first we have to see how many inputs are there. So there are only two inputs, two atomic conditions. If you come to the code, you will find there are two atomic conditions. So you have to draw this particular. So this is the condition, this is the decision. Inside this there are two conditions and you have to draw this table. Okay. Now you have to fill this. So in order to fill this, how you will fill this data? By considering the condition. So first we will take first two condition and see that whether these two condition in a combination can cover 100% condition coverage or not. That means we have to see that for red, true and false should be covered, and for wheels, true and false should be covered. So if I come to red, that means this first condition is red, and for wheels also, okay, in the second condition is also red. So this is red and this also is red. And if we go to wheels, the first one is wheels and the second one is not wheels. And if you take a decision, which is not necessary because they are only asking about the condition here, but let's see what will be the output. So both the things are satisfying. So it is red also and it is wheels also. So you will take the photo, true. But here it is red, but it is not wheels. So you will not take the photo. Now let's look into the condition. As I told, you have to cover true and false for each of the condition. But if you see here, this is also red and this is also red. And that is the reason it is not covering 100% condition coverage. But if you look to wheels, this is wheels and this is not wheels, means true and false. So for wheels, we are covering true and false. But for red, we are not covering true and false. We are only covering true and true. And that is the reason 1 and 2 is not your answer. Now again we will see these two things. One is the code and one is the condition. And to cover this thing, again we will have this table. But this time we will take two different inputs. Okay. So first input will be the same. But instead of taking second as an input, I will take third as an input now. So now if we see here, first one is red and second, third one is not red. So red and not red. And then this one is wheels. And the next one in third option is wheels. And if you see the option now, the first one will be true because red and wheels is true. Not red and wheels is false. But now if you see here for condition coverage, this is also wheels, this is also wheels. So both are true. And that is the reason this is also not covering 100% condition coverage. For red it is true and false. 100% condition is covered for red. But for wheels, 100% condition is not covered. So now let's see the next option. So question, condition, and this is the thing which we have to fill. So again we will take first option and the last option. So here it is red and here it is not red. So red and not red. Here it is wheels and the in the fourth option it is not wheels. So wheels and not wheels. Now let's see the decision. Red and wheels, true. Not red as well as not wheels, so false. Now if you look here, for red we have covered red and not red, means true and false. For wheels also we have covered true and false. So this is a combination. 1 and 4 is a combination to cover 100% condition coverage. So if we look into the answer, so A is our option. 1 and 4 are the options for condition coverage. So this is how you have to analyze the condition coverage question. That is it from this particular slide, and I will see you with the next topic. Until then, happy testing.